Hi, I'm Steve Reed, an economist at the Bureau of Labor Statistics. Today we're going to talk about one of the measures of inflation that is produced by the BLS, the Chained Consumer Price Index, or Chained CPI. The objective of the CPI is to measure changes in the cost of living for American consumers. To do this, we price a market basket of all the consumer goods and services purchased each month in urban areas across the country. The BLS publishes three official versions of the Consumer Price Index each month. You may already be familiar with what we call the CPIU, which measures changes in the cost of living for all urban consumers, and the CPIW, which measures changes in the cost of living for urban wage earners and clerical workers. Today, I want to focus on a relatively new measure of inflation that's been in the news a lot, the Chained CPI for all urban consumers. So, what's the difference? The Chained CPI differs from the U and W in two important ways. First, the weights, or relative importances, that is, the share of the consumer budget of the various consumer goods and services in the Chained CPI, are more current than the weights used for the U or the W. For example, in the CPIU and W for 2015, the categories of goods and services that consumers buy are based on expenditure surveys conducted in 2011 and 2012. So those weights are a few years old. Consumer behavior can change a lot in just a few years. Consider telephones. In recent years, the use of landlines has fallen dramatically as cell phone use has correspondingly increased. The final Chained CPI will correspond more closely to how consumers are currently spending their money. A second difference between the Chained CPI and other CPIs is that the Chained CPI reflects how consumers respond to changes in relative prices. For example, suppose the price of beef increases this month, but the price of chicken falls. While some households may not change their buying habits as a result of this relative price change, at least some consumers will buy a little less beef and a little more chicken. The Chained CPI is unique among the CPIs we produce in that it explicitly takes into account how much consumers spend on goods and services in both months. In short, since the Chained CPI uses more current consumer spending patterns and is designed to reflect changes in actual consumer behavior, the Chained CPI is designed to be a closer approximation to a cost of living index than the CPIU or the CPIW. Over time, the Chained CPI tends to increase at a slightly lower rate than other measures of consumer inflation. For example, over the 12-year period from December 01 to December 13, the Chained CPI rose at an average annual rate of 2.11%, compared to 2.33% for the CPIU. While we can say that the Chained CPI is a better general or overall measure of changes in the cost of living, there is a limitation of the Chained CPI that people should be aware of when considering which measure of consumer inflation to use. Namely, the Chained CPI is subject to four quarterly revisions. For example, Chained CPI indexes for August 2015 are initially published in September 2015, revised each of the next four quarters, and aren't published as final until August 2016. In contrast, when we publish the CPIU and W indexes each month, they are considered final when first issued. The final Chained CPI needs both current prices and current spending patterns. While we can go to stores and collect the prices right away, it takes many months to determine how much consumers are spending on various items each month. Finally, a potential limitation of all three inflation measures, the CPIU, CPIW, and the Chained CPI, is that they might not be the best measure of the changes in cost of living for each and every American. All three measures are merely averages. They measure changes in the cost of living for all urban consumers or for urban wage earners and clerical workers. Each individual family, on the other hand, has its own personal inflation rate. Indeed, these three CPIs may not be representative of specific individuals or individual families, or even for specific groups of people, such as senior citizens. In summary, a goal of the Bureau of Labor Statistics is to measure changes in the cost of living for consumers. We view the Chained CPI as a closer approximation to the true cost of living index for the average consumer than the CPIU or the CPIW. However, as I noted, the Chained CPI is subject to four quarterly revisions before being issued as final. Thanks for taking the time to learn about the Chained CPI. If you have further questions about the Chained CPI or about the CPI in general, please contact the CPI information staff at 202-691-7000 or CPI_info@BLS.gov. Also, visit us on the web at bls.gov/CPI.